of you insist that you want to still apply for jobs online. Although this is the least effective job search strategy, especially for immigrants and international candidates. If you do want to apply online for jobs, you will be up against what we call the hiring funnel and the obstacles that it presents to those who apply online for jobs. Give me just a few minutes here to explain how the hiring funnel will impact your efforts to land a job. Also, I will give you some tips to minimize the impacts of the hiring funnel and maximize your chances of getting through. If you don't know who I am, I'm Zarelsi, an international career strategist and migration mentor. During the last decade, I've helped hundreds of highly skilled international candidates land their dream jobs abroad from a distance without applying for jobs online. If you want me to personally help you, and if you are interested in a hand-holding approach through much more effective ways of landing a job internationally, then look for a link around this video somewhere where you can book a call with me so that we can get started at alternative job search strategies and I can help you land your dream job in your destination country. So let's look at what the hiring funnel is so that you can understand what you're up against when you apply online. Hi everyone, this is a quick video to explain to you what the hiring funnel is, or otherwise known as the recruitment funnel. So you can do this for yourself and go and Google hiring funnel and read about this a little bit more if you want to. I'm not going to labor the point. I just want to explain to you how this affects your chances of finding a job, especially if you're an immigrant or an applicant from offshore in another country, and how the hiring funnel affects your chances of getting through to that job. So basically, the hiring funnel is a principle that we use in recruitment. And that is what companies use to base their recruitment policies, processes, and systems on. So the recruitment funnel or hiring funnel lets applicants through basically a funnel. So here is a good visual representation of it where a lot of prospective employees or applicants will be aware of a job. But in the end, those that get out at the bottom is literally 1 to 2% of those who first become involved in the funnel. So usually from the application part where the ATS system sits, so inside the hiring funnel, around the application part, that's where an ATS system or a hiring manager will start eliminating applications. All the way to the person who gets a job is literally a 1% chance. So I'm going to explain to you the hiring funnel in a little bit of a different way. So let's look at this. In recruiting, we have known what is called the hiring funnel or the yield model for every job, which helps recruiting leaders understand how many total applications they need to generate in order to get a single hire. So this is something that companies, businesses, organizations use to make sure that they do effective hiring. But for you as an applicant, this has the effect of filtering you through a system to eliminate applications that they do not want, unwanted applications, because they get inundated with applications. So like you saw in the visual representation, around 1,000 individuals will become aware of a role. In New Zealand, we have around 250 to 400 applications per role, like it says here, but around 1,000 individuals will see a job post. So if you go on Seek, for instance, and you look at jobs, 1,000 people will do the same thing, look at the same jobs. However, only around 200 will begin the application process. And the reason there is such a big drop there is because companies or organizations put filters and blocks and obstacles and gates in your way so that you do not start that application. Some of those blocks will be the visa disclaimer that sits at the bottom of an ad that says you must be eligible to apply for this job. You must have a visa to apply for this job. You must have the right to apply for this job. You must have this. You must have that. Or sometimes it will be in the job description or the ad description where you see something and you think, oh, wow, I can't do this. I don't have this. And therefore, you will stop your application. Or it will just be too difficult. If you go through an application process online, they will pick you through this list of questions that you have to answer. And sometimes some of those questions will eliminate people. Therefore, some will begin the application process but won't finish the application process. So this is how the gates work, the obstacles work to eliminate people to not potentially continue with that application process and filter them, eliminate them, right? So this is how the hiring funnel is set up to eliminate people all the way through the process. Now, in the end, those who do complete the process, of those who complete the process, 75% will be screened out by an ATS. So this is the last part of the filtering and gates process. That applicant tracking system will literally read the application, compare it with keywords in the job description, and they eliminate most of them. So from there, that hiring manager, a person will actually see between 10 and 25 resumes or CVs, right? So literally a human will lay eyes on only 25 of those 1,000 that at the beginning saw that ad. And in the end, one will get the job. So you can see how the hiring funnel eliminates applicants by way of putting all these gates, these obstacles in front of them that they have to get through to be able to become that 1 to 2% of people to get through. And even with the interview process, there are still obstacles there. So if you apply online as an immigrant, there are even more obstacles put in your way. And this is just to show you how difficult it is to get through online applications. So I hope this explains a little bit what sits behind your struggle to get through online applications. That we know how difficult it is to get through the hiring funnel because of all these obstacles that it puts in your way, let's look at some ways to maximize your chances. If you do want to apply online for a job, ensure that you follow these tips. Number one, check for an ATS system. This is a good indicator that you will be eliminated. I have linked a video above here for you, which explains how to check for an ATS or applicant tracking system. Number two, make sure that your CV and cover letter perfectly match the job description. See the job description as a questionnaire and your CV as the answer sheet. Use similar words, terminology, and phrases to maximize your chances of getting through. You can use software such as JobScan to check every application for effectiveness. Number three, if you did apply online through an online application process where you had to add your application to an applicant tracking system or fill in an online form, which is likely ATS based, also try and find a hiring manager or a person to send an email to with your application, or find the person on LinkedIn and send a message to that person on LinkedIn. Send your application to this person with a message to the effect of, I have applied for this position, but because I'm applying from offshore, I'm concerned that my application will be eliminated by an ATS system, and therefore I am forwarding it to you for consideration. Number four, look for jobs where the application is requested by email instead of an online application to fill in a form or upload a CV, which is likely an ATS system with a filter. In this case, the employer does not have an ATS system in place because they are likely a smaller employer. I hope you enjoyed this video explaining to you what the hiring funnel is and giving you some tips to maybe get around the hiring funnel and ATS system and maximize your chances when you're applying online. Remember, applying online, what we call the scattergun or spray and pray approach, is the least effective way of landing a job, especially if you're an immigrant. If you want to learn more effective ways of landing a job abroad, and more effective strategies of getting through to overseas employers, look for a link around this video to book a strategy consultation with me so we can get started on your journey to land your dream job abroad.